Good morning, everyone. My name is Angel and I am going to be the class teacher for 4th B1 and I will be teaching you science and social for 4th B1 as well as for 4th B2. And for you, for our class, Max and English will be taught by Mrs. Gnanaselvi Miss. I hope we all will have very good time by learning through online teaching. Okay, today is our first class and we are going to take the first subject from science, the first lesson. Let us get into our topic. Science, first lesson. The topic is living beings. What do you mean by living beings? Right now, I want you to look around your house and see what are the things you can see it, like table, cot, bureau, TV, chair, etc. What do we call all these things? We call them as non-living things. Okay, now you go out of your house and see what can you find out. You may see trees around, plants around, human being walking around, or you may have pet animals. Yes, these are called living beings. Okay, today our lesson is living beings. Commonly, what are the characteristics of living beings? Can we name them? What are the things that a living beings does? They breathe, they eat food, they grow, they reproduce, they respond, they feel, they need energy, etc. Okay, in detail, we are going to see the characteristics of living beings. Okay, we all have to listen carefully to understand our subject. Now, I will show you the each and every characteristics of living beings. I want you to focus and listen to your teacher. The first characteristic is feeding. Can you see here? Feeding. This is the first characteristics of living beings. Do non-living things need feeding? No. Only living things need feeding in order to survive. All living beings need food to survive. Like plants make their own food from carbon dioxide and water. Let us see, I will show you a plant now. What is this? This is a plant. This plant needs energy, yes or no? Yes. How does this plant get energy? From carbon dioxide and water, they make their own food and it gets its energy. Do you see here root? This root absorbs water and it goes to the plants. Whole part of the plants get energy. Okay? And it enters through leaves. I will show you another leaf. If you see here, this leaf has holes in it. We call them as pores, holes in it. Through that holes, the energy also enters. So plants produce their own food. now let us talk about animals. What is this? Cow. What does the cow eat? Grasses, plants, etc. Right? What is this? Goat. Goat also eat plants and grasses. Okay. If you talk about like other animals, tiger, lions, and deer, they eat what? They eat flesh. They eat flesh. Like, I'll show you one crocodile now. This crocodile, what it eats, you know? Crocodile eats another animal's flesh. Okay. Now, this animals and plants, they have to feed themselves in order to get energy to survive. Only living beings need feeding food. Non-living things does not require any food to survive. Okay. Next characteristic is breathing. Breathing. Do we all breathe? Yes. Can we say we can survive without breathing? No. We have to breathe. Animals also have to breathe. Plants also have to breathe. Everyone need breathing. Otherwise, we cannot survive. Animals or plants, they take air to breathe. Especially plants. Especially plants take air and use oxygen into it and make energy. Like oxygen plus food combined together to produce energy. They also produce carbon dioxide plus water vapor. Through this, they throw out waste. Okay, how do human beings breathe? We all breathe through nose. We all breathe through nose. Okay, what about animals and birds? Animals also have to breathe. And what about insects? I'll show you insect picture. Do you see here insects? Like butterfly insects and other insects. They also breathe. What about birds? Birds also, they breathe. Can we say a bird can survive without breathing? No. Birds also need breathing support. Do you see the peak over here? They have holes on above or on top of the peak of every bird. Through the holes, they breathe. Even insects also have holes on their faces. So through the holes, insects breathe. What about fish? Fish also can breathe. Do you see here fish? Here, shark, whale, dolphin. These fishes, they can breathe through gills. Animals also need to breathe so that they can survive. So living beings have the characteristics of breathing. Our next characteristic of living being is throwing waste. What do you mean by throwing waste? Like animals, they eat food and after eating the waste has to go out of the body. Like animals, they eat food animals they eat food and they throw out waste through the form of urine, sweat and tools. Okay, even human beings also, we have to throw out waste from our body. I'll show you a human picture now. Human being body also need to throw out waste out of the body through the form of urine, stool or sweat. Okay, if we keep the waste within our body, what will happen? That is not good process. So when we take food, it has to be go out of our body as a waste. Okay, what about plants? Plants also throws out the waste, like they through gas. As I told you, the leaves have holes in it that we call them pores. Through that, the gases goes and comes out and it throws out its waste by air. Okay, our next characteristic of living being is responding. Can everybody say it? Responding. What do you mean by responding? Responding means, for example, if you touch a plant or pluck it one by one, if you pluck the leaves, after some time what will happen? This plant will die. It's responding. Have you heard about sensitive plant? Yes. If you touch that sensitive plant, that plant will shrink, it will close, so it responds. For example, if you take an animal, see her goat, just imagine if you disturb any animal, throw stone at any animal, on a goat or sheep, it will run away. Yes or no? That is called responding. For human being, what do we mean by responding? Responding, for example, I will pour on you a little cold water, chill water. What do you feel? You'll feel chill, coolness in your body. Or if you touch a hot water, what will happen? You will feel hot and it will burn, it will hurt you. So we are responding. Our body responds and we also have feeling. Okay. Okay, let us go to another characteristic is movement. Does animal move from place to place? Does animal move place to place? Yes, animals move from place to place. We are talking about characteristics of living beings. The next characteristic
is movement. Do we all move from place to place?
Yes, we walk from place to place. We move our bodies.
Yes or no?
Even animals also move from place to place.
Does a cow and a goat move from place to place?
Yes, they move.
Do a plant move from place to place? Or tree move from place to place?
Yes, it moves. The branches grows, stretches out, it moves, and the roots also moves, extends its area, it spreads around, so it moves. All living beings have the characteristic of movement, but non-living things does not move by its own until unless we move it. Understand? The next characteristic is called reproduce. All living beings reproduce. That means they produce young ones of their own kind. If you take animals, they reproduce, they bring their own kinds of babies, and also some animals, they give birth to their young ones, or some will lay eggs and they hatch and the babies comes out, like a hen and other birds. They give egg through egg, the babies comes out. And some of the animals, they feed by, some of the animals' babies feed by their mother's milk. Even human being, by the baby gets milk from mother and they grow. So human beings also reproduce, animals also reproduce, even plants also they grow and gives, even it spreads around, and small plants are grown. If you put a seed, or if you plant a seed, what will happen? It will grow as a big plant or big tree. Yes, so it bears fruits, flowers, etc. So plants also, they reproduce. Animals that grow up feeding on their mother's milk are called mammals. Everyone have to learn this word, mammals. Okay, what about like onion, potato? You can see in your book, yes or no? Yes,
they also grow with their roots and they bring new plants, new vegetables will come. Okay, these are called reproduction for plants. The next
The next characteristic of living beings is called growing. Is called what? Growing. Do we all grow or we are still baby? No, we have grown up. Or you have grown up like boys and girls. See here, we are, our body has grown up bigger and bigger. Yes, our hands are grown big, legs are grown larger, and your hairs also grow. Yes, human being also grow. Even animals also grows from small to big. Plants also, now the plant will look small and it will become one day tree. So all living beings grows by step by step. That is why we all living beings are called, it grows, so we all are called living beings. Does non-living things like this phone grow? No, this is just a non-living things, doesn't grow. Only living things can grow. All living beings grow. A baby grows, as I said, become maybe, see, do you see here a duck and small duckling? Yes, it grows like same kind of duck, small duckling grows. Okay, now let us revise the characteristics of living beings. First one is what? Feeding. All living beings feed. The next one is breathing. All living beings require breathing, have the characteristics of breathing. The next characteristic is throw out waste. All living beings like animals, plants, human beings, ourselves have to throw out waste from our body. Through what? Through the form of urine, stool, sweat. Okay, the next characteristic is called responding. As I said, we respond to certain feeling. Animals, plants also, they respond. The next one is movement. All living beings move from place to place. The other one is reproduce. All living beings reproduce like their own kind. Then growing. As I said, living beings grow step by step. These are the characteristics of living beings. I hope you all understood. And if you see your books, there are some activities. Yes or no? Yes. So if you get time, try to do it. And we will discuss about the question answers later. I hope you all understood. Now students, listen to me very carefully. This is a plant. These are called, this is just a plastic animal. Just imagine yourself, this is a real animal like cow, goat and other animals also. I will show you also pictures. See here, fruits. Next, vegetables. Do you see here animals, like domestic animals, wild animals? Do you see here birds? And do you also see here plants and flowers? Yes. And do you also see here sea animals? This is all called what? Living beings. Listen, students, very carefully. These living beings are very precious in this world because God has given us our life to exist on this earth. God has created different birds, kinds of birds, kinds of animals, plants and vegetables for our use. So we have to thank God for making us, creating us as a human being, as a living being. Yes. So we need to be thankful to God for our life and for the things around us. We need to take care of our environment and we need to grow more trees and we need to take care of the environment like animals, plants and our surrounding. I hope you all understood the lesson called living beings. So what are the common characteristics? Feeding, breathing, throwing out waste, responding, movement, reproduction, growing. Okay, so learn better and if you have any doubt, you ask me. Thank you all for listening very carefully. Thank you.